I'd like a list. Can you please submit a list to me of all the people involved who actually approved the statement that the Astros came out with? It didn't have any name on it. You're right. That was later when Jim Crane had to put his name on something. But then they put you in front of the cameras, and the best you could do, Jeff, listen, you put together a good team. Don't get me wrong. You're pretty good at what you and Jim Crane have done in building a winner. You lost 100 games 3 years in a row. You're trying to build a dynasty. I get it. But here's one thing you may not be that good at: sitting in front of a microphone and being a person. I want a list of names who would read that statement and think that that's the approach we should be taking. And then you were asked. I couldn't do this to you, Jeff. I should have done it, but I didn't. You were asked in that press conference, hey, have you apologized to Stephanie, the writer at Sports Illustrated, who basically was smeared by the Astros? And his response was awesome. Not. He said, no, I'm sorry. You know, it's the World Series, and I've been busy. I haven't had time. Jeff, you haven't had time to take 1 minute and apologize to the writer who you smeared and to the woman who got the whole story right from the beginning? FYI, she was sitting right in front of you as you were giving your press conference. You couldn't, as a human being, have stood up during the press conference and said, Stephanie, I'm sorry I haven't seen you earlier. I wanted to tell you I am so sorry for what I and the rest of the organization did. It's past inexcusable, and the termination of Brandon Taubman is the first step of many to making this right. Is that so difficult? What about calling Stephanie, texting Stephanie, seeing her before the press conference started? So during the press conference, he could say, hey, guess what? I just had a chance to speak to Stephanie, and I'm starting the healing process by apologizing. The Astros had a chance to get it right again. Shockingly, they didn't. They're as good as building baseball teams as they are bad at figuring out how to deal with PR and any sort of human interrelations. Well, congrats, though, Nats. You have an entire nation. Ooh, that sounds like Simon and Garfunkel. You have an entire nation rooting for you, and I sit amongst them.